everybody, and welcome to PrivateEnglishPortal.com. My name is Steve, and welcome to Business 11. My question this week comes from my business English student, Hans, from Switzerland. And he would like to know three more pointers on how to do an excellent job interview in English. The first one is less is more. This is a very, very popular catchphrase in business English circles. And what it means, Hans, is that you want to focus more on quality rather than quantity. We want to avoid pages and pages of a curriculum vitae. We know that the interviewer wants to get through the interview as quickly as possible. We want to know what you can do to make your job interview as succinct and straight to the point as possible. The bottom line is less is more. My second very important point, Hans, is be careful of word stress. We know that many words which are the same in many other languages as they are in English, the stress, the word stress, will come after where it comes in English. Take, for example, the word infrastructure. Infrastructure, we can see that it falls right at the beginning of the word in English. Infrastructure. But in many other languages, that word stress comes after. So you want to pay attention to your word stress with many words that are the same in English and your language. My third, last, and very important point is try to avoid those mistakes with open and closed vowel sounds. You want to sound as much as a native speaker as possible. And it's been my experience time and time again preparing my students for a job interview. For example, the U sound, the long U sound in English, the word culture, okay? When we say culture in English, that's a short U sound. But in many, many different languages, there's a tendency to say culture. But it's not culture, it's culture. And I want you to remember that. And that will help you do a 100% correct job interview so that you can get that job that you want. Okay? So I hope that answers your question, Hans. And I look forward to my next question next week. Bye-bye.